humanity, helping someone in need. It's frightening to imagine what life in Ontario would be like for even one day without the nearly 8 million Ontarians who give over 800 million hours of their time to more than 45,000 organizations. Just think of the good deeds that would go undone and the people who would be left wanting. We can't ever take these contributions for granted. They are too important to the health and well-being of our communities. That's why, Mr. Speaker, the Volunteer Service Award Program is so vital. We know volunteers give of their time and money without any expectation of an award. However, when we celebrate and recognize outstanding volunteers, we do more than just say thank you. Highlighting their efforts encourages them to keep up the work, but more importantly, inspires others to get involved. As always, Mr. Speaker, I want to take just a few moments to talk about my own riding of Leeds-Grenville. In the communities I have the honour of representing, there's an organization that's been matching volunteers with groups, and that is the Volunteer Bureau of Leeds-Grenville. It was founded in 1981 by Betty Haley, who saw at the time the need for organizations to assist them because they just didn't have time to recruit active volunteers. Thanks to Betty Haley's efforts, the Volunteer Bureau now in Leeds-Grenville has 15,000 volunteers, making a difference in every corner of my riding. Today, the agency is run by their executive director, Frank Rocket, and it continues to do great work. I also want to take a moment, Mr. Speaker, to give rise to discuss my colleague, the member for Dufferin-Caledon, Sylvia Jones, and her bill, Bill 38, which is an act respecting criminal records checks for volunteers. It would allow volunteers to pay for this record check just once and allow multiple agencies to access the information at no additional cost. It would save money, reduce demand on police resources, and encourage people to lend their assistance to multiple agencies. Again, on behalf of Tim Hudak and the PC Caucus, I want to have a heartfelt thank you to Ontario's 8 million volunteers. We look forward to joining all members of this House as we celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Volunteer Service Awards Program in 2011. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Member from Parkdale High Park.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And on behalf of Andrea Horvath and the New Democratic Party of Ontario, I'm proud to rise as well and herald the 8 million volunteers, tireless volunteers. But I have to say, Mr. Speaker, that some of those volunteers are becoming very, very tired these days. I was there to serve the millionth meal with St. Francis Table in my own riding. They weren't happy about it. They weren't celebrating anything. They were sadly serving the millionth meal. Churches are going, mosques are going, synagogues are going, temples are going, where governments fear to tread these days. They're going out there in their communities, they're feeding people, they're housing people, they're working overtime. The Out of the Cold program itself is running out of volunteers because they're so exhausted at doing the work that shouldn't be theirs to do. It should be the government's place to do it. And I want to also herald, particularly in light of the Ombudsman's report, the work of our tireless social justice activists. Tomorrow, as you heard the member from Eglinton Lawrence say, is Human Rights Day. Well, there are tireless volunteers who work for human rights. I think, for example, tonight I'm going to the 519 on Church Street to stand with my trans brothers and sisters who would love to see Toby's Act passed, which would add gender identity to the Ontario Human Rights Code. They've been working tirelessly to see this done both federally and provincially for many, many years now, and they're not getting paid for it. They're doing it because it's the right thing to do. I think of all of those tireless volunteers who were out demonstrating the weekend of the G20, many of whom were, for their troubles, arrested, beaten, imprisoned, for no fault of their own, but because they are tireless volunteers. They are people who give of themselves with no recompense. I personally was out there with, for example, a Tibetan community in my community who are still, you know, calling for a free and autonomous, independent Tibet. I was out there with prayer leaders and clergy of all stripes who were pushing pushed back from doing a prayer service for no reason, absolutely no reason except for an unjust law passed unjustly, as we now know. These are also tireless volunteers. Yesterday, the Ontario Association of Interval and Transition Housing came to Queen's Park. They came with a list of demands for women, the most vulnerable women and children who are being abused, and record numbers, I must say, Mr. Speaker, and they are the ones who step up, many of them volunteers, and look after these women and children. But they are tired. The tireless volunteers are getting tired. They need government help. They need housing. They need a poverty program with some teeth that actually addresses poverty, not just talks about it. They need help doing the work that is absolutely essential. And I haven't, Mr. Speaker, even touched on the volunteers in our schools, volunteers in our hospitals, the volunteers across this province who keep the province functioning. And were they to cease their tireless efforts for a moment, this province would cease to function. They sent me here, they elected me, Mr. Speaker, to come here with that very message. The very reason I ran was about poverty issues. The very reason I'm here was because I was one of them and I got tired. And they elected me to come here and to talk on their behalf, speak to a government that seems to have dropped the ball where volunteer and volunteer efforts are concerned. So from them to you, it's by way of a Christmas card, I guess, because it is that season when we're supposed to look after others. And they say they are looking after others. They're doing their best, all 8 million of them. But they're running out of resources. They're getting exhausted. They very much wish to pass the torch back to government, to pick up the mantle and to do what government should be doing, looking after its citizens, taking care of each other, housing people, feeding people, educating people, healing people. That shouldn't have to be the work only of volunteers. That should rightfully be the work of government. So on their behalf, a great deal of gratitude is owed, no doubt, and a great deal of help needs to be forthcoming as well. And Merry Christmas and to all a good night, Mr. Speaker. Thank you.
Petitions.